Hello friends, welcome to the online lecture series of CNC machines and automation. This is the first lecture of this series and I'm going to start with the unit number 1. It doesn't matter whether you have studied this course earlier or not, but if you follow this lecture series you can get most out of it. So I'm going to start this lecture. This lecture is to be taken on the date of 11th May in your lecture timing 3 to 4. So I'm going to start the unit number 1, which is the introduction and basic concept of CNC machines. I'm not going directly to the CNC machine. I will go step by step. Correct. So what are the learning outcome from this unit number 1? These are not the topic which we are going to discuss, but these are the topics which we are going to discuss in unit number 1 only. So I'm not going to directly start the CNC, but I'll tell you from where we have started this NCN, CNC or DNC concepts. We'll start from the very conventional machines that we are using in the industry nowadays and to the most advanced machines, which is called DNC machine, but step by step. Correct. If you have not subscribed my channel, please subscribe the Tiny Step channel and you can get the other lectures on this channel only. So these are the topics which we are going to discuss in the unit number 1. But what are the topics which we are following today? So I'll tell you the introduction to the NC machines, then what are the NC machine tool features and what are the components of NC machine. Correct. So I'll start with the very first, from the general or the conventional purpose machines. So as you have seen in the images, correct, these machines, this is called the drilling machine, this is your lathe machine as you already know. So what are the problems associated with these machines? First of all, it's a skill. A person who is not a skilled one, correct, he have to get the skills by learning through different peoples of the industry, then he can work onto it. Correct. Even then, you cannot create the complex parts. It takes lot much time. If you can make it, there might be mistakes. Or even then, if you are so skilled that you have completed the complex part, it will take your days to complete it. That's why we are moving from the general purpose machining to NC or CNC machines. Secondly, the manufacturing time or cost. As I told you, in the industry, time is a money. Correct. So if your manufacturing time is less, you can get the maximum out of it. But your conventional machines or the general purpose machines cannot do that. Their manufacturing time is more. That's why we are switching on to the NC or CNC machines. Then we are having the, what is the NC machines? So if I tell you about the those machines which are controlled by digits, digits means 0 to 9, alphabetic characters like A to Z, correct, and the combination of these. Fine. So if these machines are controlled by alphanumeric characters, clear. So a system in which actions are controlled by the direct insertion of numerical data at some point. As you can see in the machine, there's a small computer inside it. Even though it is not fully computerized, but a system is introduced to the machines in which you put the NC data, like your alphanumeric codes are putting inserted into these machines, and then you can do work onto the NC machines. Here in this, the direct human contact is very less. You just put on your NC machine data and you can do it easily. In what forms you can put your data in, that is in a type of punched card, punched tape or magnetic tape. Here, so the data can be taken, inserted into the machine and it can perform as per your expectations. Here, then this is the pathway of the NC machine. So first of all, we are having the input device. Input device means those in which you are inserting the program or the data, like your magnetic tape that we have discussed in the previous slide, your magnetic tape, your punched tape, punched cards are the input devices. Then there's a control unit. Control unit is that part in which, the second is your control unit, in which what you'll do, it will read the input data and give the instructions to the drive system. Correct. First of all, it will get the input data, input device. Input data is to be assessed through the control unit. It will verify it. It will check it out. Then it will give the, according to the program, it will give instructions to the drive system. Correct. Then the drive system will perform accordingly. This drive system having the different motors, correct, actuators which control the axis. Axis means X, Y, Z in which your tool is moving or your workpiece is moving. Those are the controlled axis. Your drive will control your axis and then it will perform the actual system. The actual work is performed onto this here. where your machine tool is actually working. Correct. Then there is a measuring system. Measuring is nothing but a feedback device. Correct. A feedback device is used whether whatever the program you inserted, it is correctly working or not. That is your measuring system, which will give feedback to again to the drive system. This drive system will optimize its performance or the functions or the control using this axis. Correct. So this is the ANSI machine. How do they work? First of all, the input, then control unit, then drive, then controlled axis, then the measuring system, which is connected to the feedback. The feedback is directly fed to the drive system and it will vary according to the feedback. Fine. So what are the tool features? It controls using numerical data, as we discussed that only a human being cannot directly work onto the ANSI machine. It is controlled by the numerical data, alpha numerical data. Secondly, it is having the accuracy, precision and reliability. As per your conventional machines that are not reliable, because once you have just off-minded, you can get your work wrong. Fine. But in ANSI machine, this is not the problem. Fine. Then the accuracy is more, precision is more. Then high MRR. MRR stands for material removal weight. If you are using the ANSI machines, they are so optimized, then you can increase your material removal rate. As the material removal rate will increase, you know that the productivity would get increased. Now the most important is more tool life. Why it is more tool life? Because your performance is optimized. Correct. Optimized means with the less input, you are getting out the maximum output. Correct. That is called optimization. So if you are doing that thing, then the tool life would get increased. And if we know that the ANSI machines having the reduced inspection. Why reduced inspection? Because we know that it will produce the product according to the given specification, according to the given dimension. So if it is producing, so there is a very less chances to get a product to be non-confirmed. Fine. That's why we are using the reduced inspection using the machine ANSI machine tools. Correct. Then what are the component of ANSI machine? You can see there is a program input, which is your commands or the instructions. There's a processing unit, which is called MCU. MCU called machine control unit. Then the third one is operating unit, which is a machine tool, which is actually working on. As you can see in this image, the program is fed into the machine control unit. Machine control unit will read the program and optimize it and send the data to the machine tool. In the machine tool, your axes are moving. Your work table or your tool are moving so that you can get the desired output or the desired product. So these are the three major important component of the ANSI machines. Fine. Then this is a block diagram of MCU. So MCU is the unit, correct, which is completely controlling all the functions happening onto the machine tool. Program is inserted, then there's a solely machine control unit responsibility that how to perform this task. Correct. So what are the components which are included into the MCU, machine control unit? There's a storage buffer. Storage buffer means the input data or the program is inserted into the machine, which can be stored for a shorter time in the MCU. Correct. That is a storage buffer is introduced. Fine. So in now there's an interpolation and other functions. The storage buffer, then interpolation is what? Interpolation will calculating its path. Interpolation stands for calculating its path. Fine. So the MCU is having a function so that it can calculate the path and function give the instructions according to the desired output or the program to the signal generator. Correct. Signal generator is to amplify your input signal, output signal, and gives the commands to your actuators or your motors. Fine. There's a sequence controller. Fine. This is very much important because this is the part in which you will define that which function has to be performed first. For example, if I would say if you are going to start cutting, whether the machine tool will start first or the cutting will start first or your coolant will start first. So as we all know that the coolant would start first. So how this to be controlled? This is to be controlled by the sequence controller. Correct. So which thing is to be happening first, then the second? This is to be done by the sequence controller. So this is the inside block diagram of the MCU. Correct. There's an input, storage buffer, interpolation, signal generator to the machine tool. Then there's a sequence controller, very important part. Correct. So I'm giving you some of the work to do that, although we'll discuss in the next class. What is the comparison between the conventional machines and NC machines? So as we have discussed in the previous slides, that you might have some idea that what are the conventional machines, like your lathe, simple lathe, drilling machine, milling machine, correct, slaughter machine, and what is the difference in the NC machines that we are using nowadays, correct? So you need to find out the comparison or the differences between the conventional machine and the NC machine. So you can discuss with me, you can find it out. This is a homework for you. So we'll see in the next time, fine. So you can check my videos on the Tiny Step channel. You must subscribe this channel for the further videos.